今年第14号台风小犬如今变成狂犬，周三早上9点在台东北端触陆，气象预估周四台风也将登陆台湾，美国媒体也密切关注。
Obviously, the biggest story really in the northern hemisphere is this typhoon, down to only 165 kilometers per hour now, where yesterday at this time we were 205. So it did lose a little bit of strength, but it will still be a very healthy hurricane, typhoon, cyclone, all the same thing when it does make landfall there in the southern part of Taiwan.
气象预报显示，小犬离台后会持续朝中国大陆移动。为了因应台风，福建省已经发布防台四级警报。
福建省要求位于闽中渔场、闽南渔场和台湾浅滩渔场的海上渔船务必于10月4号18时前全部就近到港避风，有序停靠并做好锚固等工作。
不止如此，当局也呼吁船上所有人员都得撤离上岸，当地许多观光景点也紧急关闭。
那适逢国庆假期，福建沿海景区游客众多，为保障游客的人身安全，福建多地发布公告，停止景区和游轮接待。
北半球除了有可能带来强降雨的台风之外，美国部分地区迈入十月还是热到不行。
It's just really hot outside, especially since it's the end of September.
每年六月中到九月底通常是美国的季风季节，但大家期盼的降雨却迟迟没有来，导致亚利桑那州凤凰城不止热死人，更创下1895年以来最干燥的季风季节。
A lot of folks kept saying that the monsoons are coming, the monsoons are coming, and I'm like, where are the monsoons at?
This year, I didn't see as much as last year.
美国气象局数据显示，亚利桑那州今年的平均降雨量不到250毫米，远远低于全国平均值的760毫米。而在南半球，澳洲才刚迈入春天，就已经热到像夏天，许多民众跳入大海想办法降温。
You know, everyone, every Aussie loves a good summer, but the fact that it's this hot now just raises the concern how hot it will get in like the middle of summer and how.Just dangerous that can be.
澳洲部分地区比平均温度高出摄氏12度，雪梨甚至已经飙到摄氏37度。东南部的维多利亚州又发生森林野火。在风速高达80公里的暖风助长下，大约1.7万公顷的土地被火烧光。当局对当地9个村庄发布撤离令。
Now it's, yeah, we are seeing changes in climate. We are seeing fire seasons start a lot earlier, go a lot longer.
位于赤道以南的印尼苏门答腊省近期也有野火窜烧。从直升机上往地面俯瞰，一整片森林被浓浓烟雾笼罩，大火已经烧毁将近27万公顷的山林，超越去年一整年20多万公顷面积。加上印尼面临4年以来最严重干旱，灭火行动困难度很高。不止人类受到酷热影响，巴西亚马逊州正在面临一场生态浩劫。当地一座湖水超过100只濒临绝种的淡水海豚、亚马逊河豚集体暴毙。
Até o momento nós tivemos uma contagem mínima de 120 carcaças entre botos vermelhos e tucuxis, sendo que a maioria, cerca de 80%, são botos vermelhos.
科学家到现场调查时，发现湖水温度已经超过39度，根本像是在洗热水澡。再加上干旱，水位太低，这些濒危海豚根本活不下去。专家警告，如果持续这样的高水温，亚马逊流域恐怕会有更多生物死亡。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载 TVBS 新闻网 APP。